RuPaul's Drag Race. Okay, I'm a little late, but I'm here, child. All right. So, leaving off from last time, Malaysia baby doll Fox ended up leaving the competition. I'm super sad. You know, I wasn't ready to see Malaysia go yet. And I felt like she had done okay. She had done decent in the competition, but it was just so much more to do. But what are you going to do? It's a competition. This is how it works. Somebody has to go at the end of the day. It's just going to be one winner. So anyway, Malaysia ended up leaving. She lip synced against Selena Estetis. And the lip sync was tragic. I did not like it. Selena apologized to Beyonce. I said, well, thank God somebody had the decency to. It was just, I gave my thoughts on it last time, child. And I'll leave, if I can remember, I'll leave my video of last week what I said about the lip sync of Single Ladies. It was a mess. It was a mess on both parts. Okay, so anyway. So the girls change or whatever. We get to Lux and Lucy. Lux and Lucy, you know, I mentioned them before as being the two delusional queens in the competition. Super talented, both of them. But just, you know, they deserve to win every single week. As if it's just them in the competition. You know, no, nobody else, just them. That's how their mind works, you know. Hey. So Lux and Lucy start to go at it about the Beyonce looks, because last week's runway was Night of 1,000 Beyoncés, and Lucy chose the look of Beyonce when she performed Love on Top at the MTV, I think, Music Awards, when she first announced that she was pregnant with Blue Ivy. And Lux started to get on her as to why she didn't have a baby bump, and you know, it was a super, like, petty argument. But, I mean, hey, why not? Let's start some mess. Okay. So, we get to the, and Mistress just in there laughing and stuff. It's funny. Mistress is hilarious, honestly. Now, listen, I've had my gripes with Mistress. I felt like she was doing the most and a lot many times. But I like Mistress, and I might be speaking too soon, but she might be the first big girl winner of Drag Race. She's a star at the end of the day. I definitely see her, you know, being the first, which is really interesting out of all these years and so many amazing, you know, contestants, who, you know, plus size divas. You know, who could easily have won, from Delta Work to Ginger Minj to Eureka, you know, Latrice Royale. I mean, you know, just so many incredible plus size girls on the show. So, very interesting. But yeah, top three, in my opinion, is definitely Anitra, Sasha, Mistress. Anyway, okay, so RuPaul comes in, and we do a mini challenge, and the mini challenge this week is to Vogue, a Vogue challenge, child. They had to get in a quick drag and everything else, child. Lux, she went first. Lux did well. Lucy's was funny with those tattoos and that wig. Selena, just flipping and flopping around like a seal, as usual. Marsha, everything is very clean and precise and bland. Sasha Colby, eight. You hear me? Sasha's that girl. I'm so sorry. Sasha is that girl. Mistress, she came along and she imitated everybody that came before her. I hollered. When she did like this, when she touched Lux's face, it, like, she was like, oh, like she got cut. And then she took some of her makeup and put it on Marsha because they're always talking about how Marsha don't wear makeup. She's so funny, Mistress. She's so good. She's so good. And of course, who came and slayed them all with the Vogan challenge was naturally Anitra. What a talent Anitra is. I mean, really. The pit crew came in, gave out trophies. Ow. That Bruno is fine. That Bruno, ooh, child. Okay, so the girls picked a can out of the ice chest, and whoever cans matched, they were going to be a team. But then it was going to be one person that was going to be by themselves because it's uneven. It's seven girls left. So Lux and Lucy ended up on the team. Sasha and Anitra ended up on the team. And Mistress and Marsha ended up on the team. So who was left by themselves was Selena Estides. So then, Rue gave Selena the option. She was like, okay, well, since you're by yourself, Selena, you have the option to either choose to remain by yourself. It was a comedy challenge. To remain by yourself or to choose somebody else's teammate as your own, which will obviously leave that person by themselves. So she snatched up Mistress from Marsha. So Marsha was left doing a comedy challenge as a non-comedy queen by herself. I said, Lord have mercy, Jesus. It was a lot for Marsha. She was over there sweating bullets. It was a lot. When I think about it, none of them are really comedy girls. Like, I mean, they're funny. They have funny moments and stuff, but nobody's like comedy, you know, just all the time. So this was definitely a challenge. Anitra had a migraine over there. She needs some Advil. It was just a lot going on. It was a lot happening. They had some practice with, what's her name? Ali Wong. She's a comedian. I like her. I'm going to follow her. And Michelle Visage, they was helping them out on their skits. Well, their comedy showcases. So Anitra, since she won the mini challenge, she was the one that picked the lineup on who's going first and who's going last. Marsha was first, second was Lucy and Lux, third was Anitra and Sasha, and fourth was Mistress and Selena. What's the name? Felt like it was strategic, the lineup. I didn't see nothing wrong with the lineup, personally. Let me see. So the girls do their thing. I really like what Mistress had on during her set with Selena. I don't know what Selena had on. I thought Marsha looked cute for her little set. I thought Lux and Lucy, they look cute in their little dresses. Who else? Anitra and Sasha. I did not like what Sasha had on. And Anitra, she was just kind of struggling, the deer in headlights. So we get a little bit to the judges' critiques. You know, actually, Marsha did well. But since it's only seven girls, and since, because of certain critiques from the judges, you know, throughout this competition, and because, like I said, it's seven girls, so they're focusing more on your mess up, your hiccups, and so Marsha didn't do too hot. Lux and Lucy was safe. No, Lux and Lucy actually won the challenge. I agree, but look, none of them were really, like, good. But, you know, you got to pick a winner. And then you got to pick somebody who, you know, didn't do well. So, Lux and Lucy, out of everybody, they did the best. And Sasha, she did well, but Anitra did not. Let me see. And then Selena and Mistress, they were safe. The runway looks was a shredded moment. My top two looks was Anitra and Sasha was giving me Destiny's Child, Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, just cut up jeans and chains, and it was just so 2000s. It was everything. Sasha stumps that runway. Shouts out to Maddie, T.S. Madison. She was a guest judge. Sasha stumps that runway, and Anitra stumps it even harder than her. Anitra had on this bad-ass black and pink jumpsuit. It was nasty. You hear me? I said, ooh, wee. Once again, I didn't like what Sasha had on. Not what Selena had on. There's only been maybe two or three runways where I've actually liked what Selena had on. I don't know. I don't know what it... I don't know. I don't know. Lux looked great, and she got a lot of points from RuPaul because Lux referenced one of RuPaul's late 80s looks when RuPaul was in a rock band in New York stomping the pavements and stuff. So RuPaul had an emotional moment with Lux's look. And I was like, oh, girl, Lux, you're in there, girl. You made RuPaul cry. And I mean, that's it, right? Let me see. Marsha, she had on the runway. She's always given a theme. She was given prime queen who got her ass whooped because, you know, the girls was mad. So they beat her to a bloody pulp. I guess it's always a theme of production. Everything goes back to Marsha's theater background, which is a great background to have. And for us LGBTQ people, that's one of the few places as a kid or while you're young to feel accepted. And so I love that. I love theater and all that good stuff. But yeah. Her runway is a hit and miss to me, too. She just always seems to be just a little bit off with something. Let me see. So who was in the bottom was Anitra and Marsha. Do I agree with the bottom, too? I guess, yeah. They lip sync to Boss, B-I-T-C-H, by Doja Cat, and it was one of the best lip syncs I have seen all season. It was incredible. All the other lip syncs, I don't even remember. The only two lip syncs I remember off this season so far is Sasha and Anitra. I'm in love with a monster, and this one with Anitra and Marsha. And little Marsha, you know, we didn't know what to think. We know Anitra is an assassin, okay? We didn't know what to think, but little Marsha held her own. Marsha three times. Marsha showed out. So shouts out to Marsha. She did her thing. She was slaying. You know, for a while I was looking at Anitra. She was eating it up. Then I looked over at Marsha. I was like, now, wait a minute. Child, Marsha hiked that little prom dress up. And she said, oh, I got something for you, sus. And Marsha did her thing. You got to pick one to win and one to say sashay to Marsha. She ended up leaving. This is Marsha's first time in the bottom, just like with Malaysia. The first time girls are going now. I don't know what's going on. But you got to pick one, right? Overall, Anitra did do better than Marsha with the lip sync. But Marsha, in my opinion, did not lose that lip sync. She was amazing. I really, really enjoyed it. Yeah. Good job, Marsha. She's going to be fine. But put on some more makeup, girl. All Marsha got to do is just apply some more makeup. Just make things bigger and grander and extra and gayer. And, you know, up the fashions a little bit and you know, make it all make sense and, you know, just bigger, broader, just extra, just, you know what to do, Marsha. Just make it more fierce and more everything. But other than that, outside of Marsha's aesthetic, she has it all together. She has everything else. Marsha is a star for sure. With that said, I'm Mr. Chalaki. Mr. Chalaki on Google+. Follow me at IsKingsWorld on Instagram and Twitter, at IsKingsWorld89 on Snapchat, Chess King on Facebook, Mr. Shalaki on Cash App and PayPal, and as always, run me my money or run me my fade. Run me my money the way I get paid. Stay black, stay tuned, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.